Hello students, today we have to move for the next continuation part in the chemistry, chemical reactions and their equations. So till to yesterday you know the balancing of chemical equations and everything. So now we have to know the few examples, more two or three examples, how to balance and everything, because yesterday I have explained only three four. Okay, so today we have to know about two or three more examples, how to balance and everything. So let us take one more example, that is the zinc. This is the one more example, zinc chemical symbol is Zn. Zinc reacts with silver nitrate. Keep in mind, zinc reacts with silver nitrate. Silver, that should be represent by the Ag, that thing you have to note down, and nitrate should be represented by NO3. So totally silver nitrate, that means AgNO3, keep that thing in also mind. Silver should be represented by Ag, NO3, nitrate should be represented by NO3. So that gives rise to, here one equation will take place, I'll tell you. So that gives rise to ZnNO3 twice, that means zinc nitrate plus Ag. So it is a little bit difficult, but you can do that balance and everything. So zinc, this is a zinc, note down, this is what, zinc, okay, and this is silver nitrate. And this is zinc nitrate, the product is zinc nitrate, and one more, silver will be separated here. Yes, zinc reacts with silver nitrate, that gives rise to, or that forms zinc nitrate and silver. So here we too also want to balance that. So how to balance? Let us write the same as it is of Euro yesterday, that is R means reactant, P means product side, clear? So here which are the elements are there, or which are the atoms are there, note down that. First one is zinc, the second one is Ag means silver, the next one is nitrogen, and the last one is oxygen. Here four elements are there, or four atoms are there. One is zinc, Zn, Ag means silver, N means nitrogen, and the next one is oxygen. So in a reacting side, here zinc one is there, then Ag also one, nitrogen is also one, but oxygen three, right? I mean one atom of zinc, one atom of silver, one atom of nitrogen, and three atoms of oxygen. In product side, here zinc is also one, nitrogen here two is here, note down here, two is here, two that belongs to both, in the sense both for nitrogen and also for oxygen. So two atoms of nitrogen, and oxygen I told you to multiply already, 3 into 2, 3 2's are 6 atoms of oxygen. And what about silver is one. So which is balanced already? Already the balance is zinc and silver. Zinc and silver is already balanced. The remaining thing is nitrogen and oxygen want to balance. That thing you have to keep in mind. Nitrogen and oxygen want to balance. So how to balance? I told you yesterday only. Let us start with one it is understood, that is commonly it is there, if it is not is there also, that is understood, there will be the one. So let us start with the two. So if we put a two here, we don't want to make zinc to balance, want to make a balance for nitrogen and oxygen, so that's why not necessary put us two on beside the Zn, I mean zinc. Okay, let us start with later, if it is not balanced we can put, okay. So let us put 2 here beside that AgNO3 in the sense silver nitrate. So what has it become? That is Ag becomes 2. So to make Ag as a 2, here we have to put 2. So now both silver has balanced, here also 2Ag and here also 2Ag. And what about nitrogen? Nitrogen check once, 2 atoms of nitrogen, here also 2 atoms of nitrogen. Yes, now it is balanced. Let us check oxygen. 2 3's are 6, yes, 6 atoms of oxygen, here 2 3's are 6 atoms of oxygen. and zinc will be here also 1 and even here also 1, because this 2 is not has given, the bracket has not given for zinc, it has given only for a nitrogen and oxygen atom. So that's why now everything has balanced. Okay, you can check again. So 1 atom of zinc, even here also 1 atom of zinc. 2 atoms of silver, even here also 2 atoms of silver. 2 atoms of nitrogen, even here also 2 atoms of nitrogen. Then 2 threes are 6, 6 atoms of oxygen, even here also 6 atoms of oxygen. Now it is balanced for a 2. Okay, did you understand? Hope you will understand better. Let us take one more example, but you want to try more in a textbook. Textbook, many sums are there related to this balancing, related to write a word equation, related to write a formula equation and everything. You want to work on that. Okay, in that first exercise part only, for that only 3 mains are there in that exercise part. You have to work on that, then hope you will understand better. Okay. Next, let us take one more example, that is the aluminium. If aluminium reacts with copper chloride, copper chloride is also known as cuprous chloride. Keep in mind, copper chloride is also known as cuprous chloride. Okay, aluminium is reacts with the copper chloride. Copper chloride also known as cuprous, because yesterday only I told you cuprous is the scientific name of copper. Copper is the general name. In the same way, cuprous is the scientific name of the copper. Here also the scientific of name of the silver. Silver is the general name, common name. And scientific name is Ag, means argentum. Keep in mind, Ag means what? Argentum. Argentum is the scientific name of silver. That thing want to know that. Argentum, not argent, okay? Argentum is the scientific name of the silver. This is aluminium, reacts with cuprous chloride or copper chloride, form aluminium chloride, forms aluminium chloride, that is AlCl3 aluminium chloride plus C. Now you have to balance for this also, that is reactant, this is reactant side and this is product side. Which are all the atoms or which are all the elements are there? One is aluminium, the next is copper, the next is chlorine, right? Okay, here don't want to separate, that is carbon like that. Cu represent a copper, Cl represent a chlorine, as you know in 8th and 9th standard, I think. No, yes. Reactant, how many reactants, how many atoms of aluminium are there in a reactant side? That is one atom of aluminium and one atom of copper and two atoms of chlorine, right? Is it? So next we have to move for this, the products in the sense, in a product side, one atom of aluminium, chlorine, three atoms of chlorine and one atom of copper. Now we want to balance for what? We want to balance for the chlorine, right? Is it? So let us start with 2 here. If we start with 2, what happened here? 2 Cu is formed, then 2 Cl2 in the sense, here 3 is there. No, it's not possible. Yes, if you try to put 2 Cu here also 2, what happened next? 2 Al it becomes, right? But 2 threes are, chlorine atom should be 6. It's not balanced at all, right? Is it tough? So here 2 twos are 4. Chlorine atom, aluminium and the copper. Okay, if you balance here also, aluminium and the copper will be get. But chlorine here 2 threes are 6, but here 2 twos are 4. So that's why, for that sake, we have to put a 3. Let us see. 3 atoms of Cu. Here also want to make 3, because Cu must be 3, no? Right? Is it? Let us check about the chlorine. Chlorine is 3 2s are 6, but here 2 3s are 6. Yes, now chlorine is balanced. Want to balance for the aluminium, that is 2 Al. Yes, are you clear about that now? Okay, don't get confusion here. 2 Al, let us check once. Aluminium, here also 2 atoms, here also 2 atoms. Copper atoms, here also 3 copper atoms, here also in a product side 3 copper atoms. And what about chlorine atoms? 3 2s are 6, 6 chlorine atoms. Even here also 2 3s are 6. Now it is balanced, right? So we want to write the chemical is what states of that also, and what about this also? What is this? Word equation also. Word equation also we can write. Aluminium reacts with aluminium plus copper sulfate. If you want to write the word equation, the same. Aluminium plus copper sulfate, that gives rise to aluminium chloride plus 3 in the same 3 Cu. Cu means 3 copper. Okay, like that you want to write. So this is the method of balancing. Hope you will understand better, but keep practicing. So let us know the next is types of chemical reaction. Mainly there are the 6 types of chemical reaction. Keep in mind how many types of chemical reaction? 6 types of chemical reaction. Okay, so which are those? The first one is chemical combination, chemical combination. The second one is chemical decomposition, chemical decomposition. The third one is chemical displacement, chemical displacement. The fourth one is chemical double displacement, double displacement. Fifth one is oxidation, fifth one is oxidation, and the sixth one is reduction. Keep in mind. Okay, so these are the 6 types of chemical reactions. Keep in mind. Okay, there are the 6 types of chemical reactions. Which are those? Chemical combination, chemical decomposition, chemical displacement, chemical double displacement, oxidation, and reduction. Yes, now let us know one by one. What is mean by chemical combination? Chemical combination means combination. The name itself says combined. Combination means combined. I mean joins together. Which are joined here? The two or more compounds or two or more elements. Anyone. Compounds are the elements. Elements in the sense single atoms or multi atoms. They are called as the elements. Okay. And what is mean by compounds? Compounds in the combination of two or more atoms. This is called as a combination. Compound. And this is called as the element. Okay. And only one single is there. Nothing is there. Ag is there only. Oxygen is there. This is called as a element. Oxygen. This is called as atom. Clear? Only one. Nothing is there. Okay. So that is called as a atom. And O2 is the element. Keep in mind. Combination of two or more atoms is called the element. A single particle is called as the atom. Combination of two or more elements or two or more atoms are called as the compounds. That thing you have to keep in mind. So here in a chemical combination, we can take the two or three elements or two or three compounds, two or more compounds, not only three, many compounds. That is called as the chemical combination. The reaction in which, get to know the meaning definitions of the chemical combination. The reaction in which two or more substances combine to form a single product, only one product has formed. That is called as the chemical combination. Keep in mind. A reaction in which two or more compounds combine to form a single product is called as the chemical combination. So example we can take here, the burning process of carbon or coal, like that. Coal we should consider, it has a main compound of carbon. So that's why coal is having a carbon mainly. Burning process means, I already told you, oxygen. Okay, oxygen for the burning process is also called as a combustion process. Main gas it required for the burning process, that is the oxygen. To lit off the fire, we require the carbon dioxide. Keep in mind. Okay, burning, wherever in an equation the burning has given, so there must should be the oxygen. Keep that thing in a mind. Yes. Okay. Yes, carbon is burning. This is the reaction of burning of coal. Coal is mainly contain the carbon. Carbon is reacts with oxygen, that forms carbon dioxide. That forms carbon dioxide. Here, two or three elements like carbon and oxygen are combined and form a single product, right? Is it a no other products in the next? So that is called as the chemical combination. I told you already while writing the equation, we want to measure the states. Carbon, coal is in a solid state. I think you know about that. Oxygen is also in gaseous state and carbon is also gaseous state. The upward arrow mark indicates the product is in gaseous state. Keep that thing in your mind. And downward arrow mark indicates the products are in precipitate state. Okay, so this is a good example. Burning of coal is a good example for the chemical combination. Coal in the sense nothing but a carbon. If it is burning, there will be the oxygen. Carbon burns with the oxygen, that forms a carbon dioxide, CO2. That thing you have to keep in mind. Let us take one more example for this. That is the calcium reacts with carbon trioxide. Reacts with carbon trioxide forms calcium carbonate, CaCO3 is the calcium carbonate. Keep in mind, okay? CO3 is also known as the carbonate group. O2 is the dioxide group. Keep also that chlorine is the Cl2 is the chlorine group. NO3 is the nitrate group. Those are all the groups you want to learn. I think you already learnt in a 9th standard, right? Okay? So, Ca, calcium, reacts with the carbonate, CO3, that forms CaCO3, I mean calcium carbonate. This is also one of the other example for what? Chemical combination. I'll recall you again, what is mean by chemical combination? Chemical combination means the reaction in which two or more reactant combined. Combination means you have to keep in mind, that is combined. Combine to form a single product. Single product, that is called as the chemical combination. That is called as the chemical combination. Let us take the next one. That is the chemical decomposition. Its opposite it is, which is chemical decomposition. Here, two or more reactants combine to form a single product. So, its opposite, I mean backward reaction it is. Okay. So, that is the reaction in which the single decomposition means, you have to get to know the meaning of decomposition. Decomposition means split up. Decomposition means split up, separation, or make into a smaller. That is called as the decomposition. The reaction in which the single reactant, here we are taking a only the single reactant. Reactant in the sense, yesterday only I told you what we have written in the left side is the reactant, what we have written in the right side, that is the product. Single reactant is break into, decomposition means split up, break, or make into simpler, that is called as the decomposition. That is that thing you have to make, keep in mind. Okay, a single reactant break into two or more product, that is called as a chemical decomposition. Good example for this, that is if you are taken ferrous sulfate, okay, ferrous sulfate break into form ferrous and sulfate separately. This is the good example for chemical decomposition. Keep in mind, okay? Chemical decomposition. Which are the example for chemical decomposition? That is what FeSO4. FeSO4 means ferrous sulfate break into ferrous plus sulfate. That is called as the decomposition. Okay? There are the three types of decomposition reaction mainly. In this decomposition, there are the mainly three types of decomposition reaction. Keep that thing also in your mind. So, which are those types of decomposition reaction? One is called photolytic decomposition. First one is photolytic decomposition. Photolytic decomposition. The second one is thermic decomposition. Or thermal decomposition. The third one is electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic decomposition. These are the types of decomposition. Which are the types of decomposition? Get to know that. Photolytic decomposition, thermal decomposition, and the third one is electrolytic decomposition. So what is meant by photolytic decomposition? The photolytic decomposition means the decomposition takes place. The decomposition takes place by the effect of photo. Photo means light, sunlight. The decomposition takes place by the effect of sunlight. That is called as the photolytic decomposition. Keep in mind, photolytic decomposition means the decomposition takes place by the effect of sunlight. By the effect of sunlight. That is the good example for photolytic decomposition. Which is, definition for photolytic decomposition. Let us take example for this photolytic decomposition, or also known as photo decomposition. That is AgCl, I mean silver chloride. So it has separated. So here one product, single product split into two or more, I told you already. With the help of sunlight, it has split into Ag and Cl, Ag plus Cl2. So let us balance this. Is it balanced up? No, not because Ag, Ag is balanced, Cl is here one and here two are there, right? Is it? But these are all balanced. If he is also one, SO4 is balanced, okay? But here not balanced. You have to balance the, that is, if you put a 2 here, here also 2 Ag and Cl2, it is balanced now, okay? Sunlight, photolytic decomposition means the decomposition takes place in the presence of sunlight or by the action of sunlight. That is called photo. Photo means light. That thing you have to keep in mind. Photo means not an image. Even why it has photo, image is called as a photo, your image and everything, because it has taken with the help of a light only. Without the light, your image not possible to catch, I think, through the camera. I think you know about that. So that's why it is called as photo. Photo means, that meaning is light. Photo means light. So photolytic decomposition means decomposition takes place by the presence of light, is called as a photolytic. Example, 2AgCl, here also one single reactant break into two with the help of sunlight. That is, next, what is thermal decomposition? The second one, decomposition takes place by the heat. Very important, these three most repeated questions, keep in mind. Decomposition takes place by the heat, with the help of heat, or takes place by the action of heat, anyone we can write. That is called as the thermal decomposition. Let us take example for thermal decomposition. This is the example for photolytic. This is the example for thermal decomposition. Let us take example, that is CaCO3 that gives rise to CaO plus CO2. CaO plus CO2. CaCO3 means calcium carbonate. Keep in mind. So CaO means calcium oxide and CO2. CO2 means carbon dioxide gas. It is in a upward aroma, when it is also upward aroma. Here photolytic displaced by the heat. This is the symbol to represent the heat. Triangle shape is a symbol to represent the heat. That thing also keep in mind. Where there is a symbol, there will be the reaction takes place with the help of heat. That shows the reaction will take place with the help of a heat. So try to balance this now. Ca, one atom of Ca, here also one atom of Ca, not need to balance. Here carbon atom one, here also carbon atom, not need to balance. And here 3 atoms of oxygen, here 2 plus 1, 3 atoms of oxygen, no need to balance. So now it is already balanced, not there, our work, okay? So that is called as thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition means decomposition takes place by the action of heat. This triangle shape represents heat. Where there is a triangle shape is there in a chemical reaction, that reaction has takes place with the help of heat. Keep in mind if they are asking you for the examination in MCQ. Next, the last one, that is the electrolytic decomposition. What is meant by electrolytic decomposition? I think you know about that very well. In a voltmeter, I mean voltmeter is a device used to separate the hydrogen and oxygen ions in a water, right? So here we are taken that example only. The decomposition takes place with the help of electric current. With the help of electric current is called as electrolytic decomposition. So with the help of electric current it has takes place. Here water is split up into hydrogen and oxygen, that is H2 and O. Oxygen. Here check, is it balanced or not? No, oxygen is not balanced. Hydrogen, okay, some of it is balanced, but oxygen is not balanced. So that's why we have to put 2 here, 2 2's are here, 2 2's are H, and oxygen is also balanced. Did you understand? So this is the electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic decomposition means decomposition has to express with the help of electric current. I mean, if you pose an electric current to the water, it split into two atoms, that is hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, hydrogen and oxygen molecule is separately collected in a different test tube. That is a great example for the electrolytic decomposition. Keep remember all these three types and the examples are very important, very 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 important and most repeated questions for your examination sake. So next period we have to continue with the other four types of equation. Till that, I think, hope you will understand. So thank you all.